We live in the plastic age. When you wake up in the morning, take a look around you. Your bed, your nightwear, the blinds in the window, they all contain some form of plastic. Your breakfast depends on plastics too. Plastic packaging keeps your milk and cereals fresh. And your journey to work would also look radically different without cars, trains or airplanes built using composites and plastics. But why have plastics become so essential in today's society? It is because of the unique combination of benefits that only plastics can offer. They are versatile in both production and usage. They are also seemingly cheap to use and produce. And they are durable and light. This is the result of combining polymers and additives in many different ways in order to create a variety of plastics with a wide range of properties and characteristics. From stands that help prevent heart attacks to the specialty foils used to make solar panels, which are so important to the energy transition. And plastics help us to develop fuel-efficient cars and electrical cars as we replace heavy steel with strong, durable and lightweight plastics. Since World War II, our consumption of plastics has boomed. And because of the lack of real alternatives, TNO believes that we will continue to be dependent on plastics for decades to come. But today's plastics come with significant downsides. The first concern is plastic waste. Most of the plastic waste collected in the EU is burned for energy recovery. This produces energy that can be used to heat people's homes, but it also destroys a valuable base material that could be used to create new plastic products. The second downside is that plastics are a major source of greenhouse gas emissions. Over its life cycle, 1 kilogram of plastics will result in 4 kilograms of CO2 emissions. And the production of plastics leads to other emissions as well, such as particulate matter, nitrogen oxide and sulfur dioxide, which also have an adverse effect on air quality, acidification and eutrophication in the environment. Thirdly, abrasion and degradation of plastics result in micro and nanoplastics, which contaminate our air, land and oceans. Although the environmental impact of plastics is the focus of much scientific research, international policy and public debate, little consideration has been given to the potential impact on public health. Plastic waste, microplastics and CO2 emissions represent some of the hidden costs of plastics to our society. We see 4 types of hidden costs due to today's mass consumption of plastics. The costs of cleaning up oceans and land, higher healthcare costs due to poor air quality or contamination with microplastics, production losses in economic sectors such as agriculture as a result of plastic pollution, and the loss of biodiversity. Meanwhile, it is estimated that if nothing changes, the global demand for plastics will quadruple by 2050. That means that plastics will account for 20% of total oil consumption by that year, and up to 15% of the global annual carbon budget for 2050. Where is this heading? If we fail to take action as a society, TNO predicts that citizens and the victims of environmental and health damage will increasingly start to question companies' policies or their license to operate, as well as the use of plastics. We envision a future in which we can still reap the benefits of today's plastics while having done away with the current negative impact. Our recommended solution is a radical switch to circular plastics. Society and industry need to stop thinking of plastic as waste and need to start thinking of it as a renewable resource that needs to be handled correctly. Why does TNO see this as the only viable option for the future of plastics? Let's look at an alternative option, such as replacing the fossil feedstock that is currently used with biomass. This would only partially address the issue of greenhouse gas emissions. Additionally, bio-based plastics would still lead to plastic waste and litter, and they wouldn't solve the other hidden costs of plastic either, because the plastic products would ultimately still end up being incinerated or being disposed of without being reused. Hence, bio-based plastics would not provide a solution to the existing drawbacks of plastics. But what if we eliminate plastics altogether and reverted to using other materials instead? Would that provide the solution? Scenarios for a world without plastics show that this will be the opposite of a solution. Replacing plastics with new or existing materials, or no materials at all, would actually double the energy consumption. And as a result, greenhouse gas emissions would go up too. The results also show that this scenario would likely result in severe economic damage. The alternatives to plastics have serious negative effects, and they don't have the essential and unique functionality of plastics. Therefore, we should instead accelerate the sustainable circular use of plastics. It is the only viable way to reduce our plastic consumption footprint, and we need to do this fast, because our welfare and well-being are at stake.